What is good, guys? I decided to record a short on life with a team I made around Charizard Y and Subcoil Toxic Zygarde, because I wanted to record SBL, but the games got like rescheduled. They were meant to happen now. I think the NJMP game got rescheduled, and also the ABI was a Sabala game. So we will just hop on the ladder. I should not have that many points on this account. But yeah, it's all good. I made this team like last week and it was pretty decent. I had a Skarmory over Bronzong, but I wanted to test Bronzong because I was kind of weak to double dance Landers. Ferrothorn is a bit annoying because I took off HP Fire on my Tangrowth. I really like Rock Slide on Tangrowth to lure in Zards. It like works. Like it worked in testing. I catched Zard, it switched hard on Rock Slide. That was so funny. So I don't really see how he leads over the Zard wise, so I will just click that button. And this is obviously Rooks. Now he could be Scarf Jump, so yeah, I shouldn't stay in here. I should just go hard into Feeny here, because if he's Scarf, he might go for Rock Slide or Edge. And if not, he will just go for Rocks. Yeah, he misses. No reason to stay in, and now I can just double back, predicting his Ferrothorn. No, I don't see a reason not to make that play. Okay, Magearna also works. I know why he went Magearna, but I can just fire off a flamethrower here. Got the cherry that Y action. Type of Feeny will take a lot. I can just solo beam the following turn. Like, I'm modest that because I wanted to have like the powerful hits. I'm completely fine with him going guard jump. Did it a lot. I can just go on a Bronzong here, I think, unless he goes for Fire Fang. He should not go for Fire Fang when I have a Tapu Fini. Yeah, he goes for Poison Jet, predicting Tapu Fini. Call it a prediction. And now I can get up my rocks. Or I can double back into Zard, but doubling back into Zard is kind of not the play, I think. Like, he's probably going Ferrothorn. Oh, he goes Ninja, okay. Like, I can just... Okay, Ninja is a threat if it has Gunk Shot. But I'm just gonna throw my Tangrowth here. Okay, he's Ash Ninja, that's fine. Heavy Tangrowth checks that like all day, every day of the week. I don't see myself losing this up. I'm already put in a like, good position, but we shall see. Let me actually check how many points I have on this account. I should be around like 1400-1500, because I haven't used this account that much since I actually did a road to top 10 on this account, but the pre-bank ladder got deleted, so I had some points, but decay popped in, so I lost a lot of points. This is In this scenario, it's really annoying that I took off HP Fire on my Tangrowth as I actually DC'd. So I checked my points and we are at 1530. So let me pause it till I'm back. Okay, and what are we gonna do here? We can just go hard Zard. I don't see what's wrong with doing that. He's probably just gonna grab his own rocks or his bike. And we can just click Flamethrower because I don't care if he has like his chomp. Oh yeah, just sexes Ferrothorn. That's really nice for me, because Ferrothorn is annoying for his team. My main way of dealing with it is the Zard. And I can just click Solar Beam here, like... I don't see what's wrong with doing that. Unless he flinches me. As he doesn't flinch me, we pick off this Greninja. I guess that was a bit risky. And, now I can just go type of Feeny if he really wants to go for Poison Jab again. Or Earthquake, that's fine. He goes for Earthquake for no reason when I have a Bronzong. Like, I showed Bronzong was my switching last time, but yeah, I will still just go for D4Q because I need a Rocks gone for my Zard. And I'm just gonna bring my Bronzong here and get my Rocks back up. I really don't know what this guy's doing. Okay, he predicts that. Did he predict that? I mean, this is fine, like. I can just go Zygarde here, there's no way he HPIs on this specific turn. Yeah, he just goes for Heatwave. I don't think he has, like, he can afford to run Heatwave and HPI, so I'm gonna sub up. Okay, he has HPIs, never mind. I forgot people consider this thing as a huge threat. I thought he would have Roost, T-Bolt, or Voltage, or Discharge, plus Heatwave, plus either Defog or Toxic, but I guess I'm wrong, and it makes sense, because he's kind of weak to Zyrid, and I'm as a Toxic. Okay, let's not choke this game away, it's getting really annoying. I mean, Tangrowth would have been a better play always in that scenario, I guess. I didn't think he would have the combination of Heatwave and HPIs, but it's whatever. I can just knock off here. Yes, he tries to discharge para me, okay, I don't know why. Gets a static para. So he's dead set, so he's defog on Fini then. I guess he predicted me going Zard, that's why he went for that play. I mean, I can just rock slide this. And I can bring my Zard in on a turn that he's forced to roost, maybe. So we hit the rock slide, that did nothing. I'm actually bringing my Scarf Lele in here to get some nice regen. And we can fire off Psychic. If Magina comes out, we still have a Switchin in the bag in Bronza. And his Fini will almost be 2-KO'd. Take Nature's Mana, so this is completely fine. But yeah, this team is still work in progress. I built this in like 5 minutes, and the only change I made was like put Scarm over Bronza. What else did I want to tell you guys? I'm uploading like a lot of FPL content. If you missed any games, like, I get it that people cannot watch every game because I upload way too much FPL content. I just want to get the uploads done for FPL week 3, because week 4 is already going on. I already upload 1 week formage. So yeah, if you didn't follow as he runs Focus Blast for some reason, I'm beginner, he deserves to miss that for having Focus Blast, in my opinion. Just forfeits, okay. So what was I about to say? Yeah, if you missed any games, just check out the playlist. I'll link it at the end of most of my videos, and if I don't link it, it's also down in the description. Or just click on my channel on my playlist. I think this guy has a team from the forums. Let me just pause real quick. No reason to pause. I meant to change some settings. I forgot what I wanted to change. Okay, so what would be a good lead? I'm not sure if it's Zardwire or X. I feel like Tangrowth is a really decent lead overall. I don't see him leading with his own Zard, but that would be a bit threatening if he does. Oh wait, someone said Zamrock is playing in a few minutes, so yeah, I might have to like pause this live and... God, my internet died. Okay, so I lost the last match to Disconnect Magnet and was super dead. We are back now a few minutes later and we got a new game. We say have fun to this man as he has some new offense. I can see him leading with T-Tar. The Rockstar and Z-Move Tran. I think he would be the Rockstar Z-Move Tran. So I think Zard is just a good lead with him overall. Oh, he's Balloon Trent, so he's not Z-Move. If he has Stone Edge, I will say nice counter team. And will hopefully dodge, but I'm staying here and going for the Focus Blast. I don't care. We hit out here, yeah, exactly. Nice damage. She gets his rocks up, and I kind of want to fire Flamethrower here, predicting his Letty. But yeah, just focus blast again is fine. As we miss, that is about to be expected. We can just go for the next one and hit this one. So yeah, we take some unnecessary damage there, but what can you expect? It's focus blast. Like, who hits focus blast anyway? I can be glad enough that I hit the next one. So, why did he bring this out? Is he Scarf Tower? He's not Scarf, he just sacked his Cheetah. Ah, nice, we hit out here, I risked it. I don't know if that was my best play, but I didn't want to switch out and get pursued it. And this is a free Tangrowth here. If he goes for Pump, I don't really get that. That was a free Volt Switch for him, in my opinion. I guess in case I would have gone Zygarde, he wanted to do that play. Not having HP 5 is annoying, because he can just go on the Scissor here. He's probably Mega Scissor, but yeah, I will just click Knock Off anyway. Not much I could have done. I'm kind of with the Scissor, but Scissor dead low because rocks are up. So I think I have to go hard Lele here to check the Scissor. Actually, I don't have to go hard Lele. I could have gone Fini and default and brought Lele later. I think that would have been the better play, honestly. Yeah, just going Fini and get a default up would have been a better play, but whatever. Like, nothing's going my way today, like I disconnected earlier. And another recording, I already didn't get recorded, but yeah, let's just focus on the positive now and concentrate. Actually, uploading Zanlock versus get this money for you guys. Let me actually upload the thumbnail. That game was like really fast. But yeah, if you haven't seen it yet, I'm not gonna spoiler the game. And even though I will upload the Zanlock game before this shot on live, as this guy takes his sweet time. Let me pause it for him, never mind, there he goes. So he kind of forces me to stay in here and break his disguise. Don't I need this to check the... I think I need this to check the Scissor. So I'm gonna go Fiend. He just goes for Shadow Ball, gets a crit. Because Pokemon is a good game. And I'm just gonna default this rocks away. I feel like I should run a bit more bulk on this Fini. That crit didn't do that much, but like I'm running like 96 speed on this Fini. I think that might be a bit too much speed. And I probably lose out a bit on bulk as Zanlock video is ready, so let me upload that for you guys. Not bad. Yeah, this guy's taking his sweet time, let me pause it for him. Okay, so the dude switched out to Rotom. Didn't want to get his disguise broken. I can get behind that play. And I can just go hard as I get here unless he's HP Ice, but Rotom, he cannot touch me. He tries to Volt Switch, that's funny. And I can just sub up on this, right? Like, I don't think these carry HP Ice. Like, he's kind of weak to Zygarde, but still. He goes hard Latios. Yeah, I should just get up damage on this. He's a life up, so we get to see his set, which is pretty nice. I have a bronze on right here, but he might be HP 5, so I feel like Tangrowth is the better mid ground play. Like, I don't need Tangrowth this game. Eat up that Draco, and he's either gonna go Scissor or he's gonna like, I feel like Tapu Fini is a good mid ground here. He's at minus 3, can't do much damage if he stays in, and if he goes Scissor I can at least Nature's Madness dead or taunt. I will probably just Nature's Madness if he goes Scissor, but I don't know why this guy is taking so long just to click buttons. It's Pokemon. Yeah, he goes Scissor. Doubling the Zard would have been really good, but that was too risky. He couldn't afford to make that play if he stayed in. Yeah, I can just Nature's Madness. As he goes for Bullet Punch. And I think I can go hard into Zard. He might U-turn a Roost. He's probably gonna U-turn, he breaks the middle taunt. But in case he stays in the bull punch, I don't want Fini to get too low, but yeah, he makes that U-turn play. Catches me on that, but that's all good. I can just go back into Tangrowth. He goes for T-Bolt. And I'm just gonna click on knockoff here. See, Sexus Light, he gets a crit. That actually did nothing. What? Life of Draco Meteor crit at 43. Tangrowth is so... What? Tangrowth has bad Spidef, but I guess it's so bulky with AV makes Spidef investment. Okay, so Scissor comes out. Huh. Fini's kinda nice to keep. But yeah, still don't see what I lose from going hard Zard here. He keeps U-turning. I could have gone Bronzong there too. I'm still in a good position, but I have to be a bit careful. I'm not playing this end game too well. I'm kind of rushing my plays. Okay, this man brings out his Mimikyu. Flygon beats Rotom, but Tangrowth also beats Rotom. So. Now Bronzong is pretty much a free play here. Wait, I completely forgot that Bronzong is weak to Shadow Claw. Yeah, I have a disease. I don't know what I'm doing. Like, I actually don't know what is wrong with me. What the actual fuck? But yeah, I don't need Bronzong, so I guess my play is okay. I want to break the disguise of his Mimikyu. And he can go for SD. I don't really care because I always have Tapu Lele to revenge him anyways. Wait, he goes for Z-move. Never-ending nightmare blows me away. And I can go for Psychic here. I mean, his scissor's pretty low, right? So yeah, he cannot switch his scissor. Not sure if Psychic kills, but Psychic to run boost, it should kill him. Timid Scarf Lele. Like, Lele's not even that strong, but... I think my laptop or my microphone is not getting picked up. Yeah, he actually lives that well. Did I just lose to this? I might have just lost to this. He crit my Fini early, that was annoying, but I definitely misplayed this. God. Oh, we dodge a player off, that's some sweet justice, I'm not gonna... Okay, I will concentrate on the next game. I play the skin poor. I mean, just hard Zygarde on the Rotom always. But good god, did I play that game poor. I guess we can coil up. Nice dodge. You can just Thousand Arrows this. Tweet KO him. And the scissor kind of win from there, but yeah, the pair of dodge was annoying for him. Sorry for Hex, dude, not much I can do. We'll just hopefully win the next game without Hex. Vertex, oh god, I actually know this guy. I'm gonna get blown away. This guy has his entire gang joining. Okay, only one dude. So he's probably like Rocks, Marowak, Z-move, Landorus. I don't see how he beats Zardwai is just such a good lead. Like, I don't care if he has a Marowak, I'm just gonna treat KO that. Oh my god, damage. I mean, I almost died, but that's fine. We got rid of the Marowak, we take those. I think like he was like max attack for sure. I can just go Bronzong. I assume he's just U-turning if he's Ashgrin. Yeah, exactly. I don't know if I would have lived that because I fought on Scissors. Yeah, cool to too cool to get this guy on the ladder. I think he posts teams in the forum. I have bronze on the Czech Landris. I guess this might be his rocker. Okay, it's just his rocker. So we're just gonna exchange rocks then. We'll probably have to set my Zord off. So he goes kill Leo. I mean, I can just go Tangro then. Keep my Zarda fodder for later as he goes for calming. Okay, this is really annoying. He's probably the Z-move Breakneck Blitz kill here. That Giga Drain did nothing. This is bad. Do I need this Tangros? Kinda need it for the Ash Ninja, but I also... Yeah, he goes for Z-move. Okay, that kills? What? And SBL did nothing when it was plus one. And SBL actually did nothing versus versus a Tangrowth. He might just go Metagross here, but I don't think I can afford to make an aggressive play here. If he goes Metagross here, yeah, I still think I have the Psychic. Yeah, I'm not playing around with this Keldeo plus one. I almost double switched. It's Heart Ninja. Let me think this through. If he U-turns, yeah, he can just U-turn here. No risk for him because I'm faster. This is interesting, dude. I have to keep this Feeny healthy for his ninja, so I cannot stay in and take an Nature's Madness. So what's the sack here? Like, I either go Tapu Lele, oh, I sack my Zord, but I think I have to go tap a Lily here. Oh no, like Nature's Madness. And then I can go for Moonblast here. Stay then, okay, damn, I should have gone for Psychic. Okay, I think I misplayed this one. Could I just go Bronzong now on this? Mega Metagross the big threat. Gets a crit, no freeze. Thank the Lord, and I'm just forced to go for Earthquake. Because Meta is such a huge problem. Goes Feeny, Kiki. Don't I like... He's never gonna defog for me, so... I think I just jarballed this. That did nothing, what? He's just bringing this down so he can beat me with Metagross. I'm not playing this too well. But I hope that I can live a Moonblast from that range. I mean, we are up 5-3, but three of my mons are basically dead. And he has Ice Punch and this, so yeah, I'm forced to defog after this, and then Ash Ninja just becomes a huge, huge problem. Zard only gets a kill versus the Lando. So I feel like I can just sack Zard. Actually, what does Bronzong even do at this point? Bronzong does nothing, so I can just sack Bronzong here. He hits. Go Feeny defog. Because I have to. I have to keep this now. Do I go hard Zygarde? No, he's gonna mash you for sure. I have to rely on my scarf letter to check his start. I don't think I can switch. He risked a T-punch when I have a Zygarde. I guess he could just come for the thing next turn. It would be weak. Yeah, I messed up. I just died to Ice Punch. Yeah, I messed up completely. Yeah, I don't know where I messed up. That this is like... This is like disheartening. Ooh, we get a crit? We get a crit with the HP fire? They call me lucky and bad. Lucky hacks. I still lose. Wait. Yeah, I still lose. He makes the rocks play there. Oh, damn, this is close. But yeah, I fucked up. I just got rewarded with a lucky crit there. I got a bank on choke. I got a roost on. That's like my only play. But he's gonna earthquake. He's smart. Yeah, he's smart. Yeah. I honestly don't know where I exactly fucked up. Probably letting my Bronzong get too low. I gotta get one more now. I cannot end on that. Yeah, like, I didn't play that well at all. I don't know what's wrong with me. I shouldn't be playing Mons at 1:30 a.m. Like, I knew the guy's decent, but still, I feel like I could've won that if I didn't, like, play like dog shit. This guy is a weird team, he has no mega. Sand is actually kind of scary, people don't prepare for it that much. I used Sand myself yesterday, worked out pretty well. Again, like, Zard is just such a good lead. I don't know why people don't have much for Zard, right? Okay, he has a Coco. So I guess he saw my lead coming. I'm not gonna... Like, I don't wanna take a full switch. I guess I could've predicted that, but he could've had U-turn. So there was no point in going Zygarde. Is he like gonna try to set up a sub or some shit? And if he has like poison shit, that's really annoying. Sorry, that's sad. Yeah, exactly. That set is so annoying, dude. There are like so many threats in Sunderman, you cannot check everything. But yeah, I don't think it was the team's fault that I lost that last game. I think I just played poorly. I didn't think my playthrough, I played way too fast. I'm just gonna need just madness here. Predicting his Bulu. Okay, he goes Trend, that's even better. He's lefty, so I can taunt him. Oh, he's fast Trend. I can still taunt him and I can defog. Because I cannot afford, I cannot have rocks on my side. Okay. Would he be HPIs? I don't think he would be HPIs. But going Zard is risky as shit. Now let's just go Zard. And I'll fire off that Focus Blast. He goes Tyranitar. Why did you go Cheetah? Like, I either Earthquake if I'm Zarex or I Focus Blast. As he gets bailed out with a dodge. So this could be Scarf Tower, which puts me in a bad position. But yeah, I think I have to go Tangler here. Actually, Zygarde would be a potential play. Why did he go Buzz Ball? Like, what? He ripped my Zygarde on my Tangles, I get it, but... Damn, dude. Goes Coco, I mean, I just got lefties on my fingers, so I didn't lose anything. And I can just go back to my Tangles. If I hit that Fox Blast on his Cheetah, I'm put in such a good position, but of course, Fox Blast, I mean, yeah. It's my bad for relying on Focus Miss. I can only go for Earthquake, but... I need this for Coco, so let's just go Zygarde. Hard Zard would have also been a potential play. Go for Fire Blast, thank the Lord I didn't stay in there. I mean, I can just... I can double into my Zard here, predicting his Buzz Ball. or he goes bull, that works. I think I have to scout for scarf bull, so yeah, we'll just go hard bronze on here. Scouting for potential scarf stone edge, because that's nothing else. Like, there's no way I'm staying in here risking my Zard. Like, some of these monsters have to be Scarf, either the Bulu or the Cheetah. I guess he doesn't have to be Scarf, because he has a Rush Excadrill, so yeah, if you just focus Blast, I guess that would be fine. Well, now I'm in a really bad position, especially if he's banned. I think he is banned, and he gets the defensive grip. The defense up didn't really matter, but actually, yeah, there was a roll, so it could have mattered. Yeah, this is just so bad, I don't know what to do now. But I feel like I had to scout for him being Scarf Bull. Normal Feeny gets weakened, which sucks. He lets his Bulu take the damage at least. And we will find out if he's a lefty. Okay, grassy terrain. We just go back bronze on here. As he home leeches, I don't get that play. And I feel like Earthquake is a good play here. Now doubling to Zard is the play here. He stayed in what? Two sword stands? Okay, that makes sense. And I can just flamethrower here. Yeah, he does not speed me. I feel like Focus Blast is the play here. Yeah, there's no way he's staying in. Please hit, please hit. As we... Come on, like, why do I even try to predict? Dude, just hit this one, just hit this one. He's not Scarf, he had way too much. As we miss again. Welp, he goes for Bandit Pursuit. Like, what am I supposed to do? This is just not fair. Of course he takes advantage. This guy is scum. He just took advantage of me missing twice. I think that was the third miss. He just took advantage of them. What a scum. Like, get out of here if he watches. You absolutely scum. Like, I don't care that... Yeah, it's a game you want to win, but that's just not nice. You scum, hello? What if I go to Zygarde? This guy's... Why would you vault switch? I have a Zygarde, dude. Like, I'm so mad. This guy's bad. I outplayed him there with a double. Like, I'm getting salty now, yeah? For no, like, I shouldn't talk bad about him, but like, I made that nice play there, doubling, like, going hard Zard on either him doubling or going for SD or something. Then I focus best and predicting Gotar, missed, go focus best again, missed. Like, this is so annoying that I'm so pissed. I will just earthquake this. I don't even give a fuck. Fuck your trend, get out of here. At least that killed. Holy shit, this game sucks. Like, last game, yeah, I didn't play optimal, but this game, come on. Like, I played okay this game, and I just... Dude, don't... People are gonna say in the comments, oh, you could've used HP fighting or Earthquake. You don't wanna miss, don't use Focus Blast. So, okay, Buzzle. My Feeny's already low, which sucks. But I have to go Feeny here, and I have to like, defog. He gives me the defog, which I don't really get. He could just double the Coco there and not giving me the defog. But I lost my Feeny, which is also really bad. I have to go back to this. He can just go Cheetah here and... I have to make a bridge near and Roost. As he just stays in a Kalos. Okay, never mind, he goes for Leech Life. Okay, let's just go for him. So, of course he switches to Cheetah that turn. As knowing this guy, he will go like Coco or some shit on the Focus Blast, so let's just roost. Yeah, exactly, this guy's making some weird predictions, and I get that play, but that was so obvious. But he got me on that turn by staying with Bulu, so I cannot say anything. I'm just gonna go Changos again. If he keeps on Volt Switching, like, this is bad, he shouldn't do that. Yeah, he U-turns this time. Finally, he turns. He should have done that way earlier because I have a Zygarde. So he's sub Earthquake Leech Life. Probably Focus Punch in the last slot. I feel like I have to go hard Lily here, because I cannot. He's probably gonna focus punch you and predicting Mazard. Oh, he's just gonna sub. He's just gonna sub, okay, and we get. Like, I get it, but I also don't get it. Moonblast is the play because he has a cheetah in the back. That did 5 million. Yeah, this is just bad. And if he goes drill now and he's mold breaker, that's also really bad. So I kind of want to double on the drill, but it's fine. I'm just gonna click Moonblast here. Why did he go to cheetah? Yeah, I just don't understand how this guy is playing. He could have gone to drill. Okay, I guess he doesn't know if I'm Scarf. Now he can go hard drill if he wants to. Actually, yeah, he messed up play. I guess that was a nice play on his part. And I mean, when Bronze on Waltz does, he's not mold break or anything. He makes a nice double, but yeah, this is really bad. I'm in such a bad position now. I'm forced to go Zard. And I hope, hope I can live a focus punch for some, but I don't think I will live that. Hammer arm. Okay, we'll live a few. I don't know if he would sack his teacher here. Yeah, I'm just gonna roost. As few, we get that play correct. Dude, I'm like doing everything to win this game, but it's just hard. Please connect this fuck F. We miss again and he crunches me. And I'm just so mad that I'm gonna drop some dashes in the chat. Like, I know it's focus blast, but come on, I missed 4 out of 5. Like come on, dude. Like, what is even my play now? Go for a game with Zygarde? Like, what options do I have anymore at this point? I needed my Zard to kill his Boswell. Like, I can go for Zygarde and like, nah, I just lose this game. There's not much I can do. I can coil. I guess I can toxic his pool, but it's not gonna save me. At least we hit. I can go bronze on here. Okay, that did a lot, and I can get up rocks here, but the thing is he just gets up a sub with his buzzle. Okay, never mind, all the Pomelang is gonna blow me away. Yeah, not much I can do. Like, if I hit any of my focus blasts, Mazard could have won this game. My, like, his sand would have been gone, so he lost his sand for his drill. But yeah, you guys can tell me if I like still could have played it better. The last game, I'm sure I could have played better. Like, I'm gonna have to rewatch that and see what I did wrong. But this game, like, I played fine in my opinion. Like, you can correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. Like, I just lose to Boswell now if it gets up a sub. That did so much too. I cannot do anything. I have to, like, yeah, okay, he's going for the flinch too. He doesn't get it, so at least he make it a bit closer. He died a sandstorm and I have to like go to Zygarde and hope I'm okay. I should have toxic there predicting his buzzle. I have to pray that I'm faster, which I am, and I can toxic this. Damn, I should have coiled on the switch. Okay, he goes for that and I can coil on him now. I think he gave me a slight chance to come back now. Yeah, I think he fucked up big time because I can sub now. The dude actually is trying to choke this away. Hard sub on the Bulu. Just coil up. Goes for his D. I just sub again. I just substitute spam. Okay, he has deed again. I mean, I just substitute spam. You're not beating me. Thanks to Grassy Terrain, I'm getting all the recovery. Yeah, like, okay, never mind. Actually, yeah, sub spam is fine. The tox, like, he's getting health back. Yeah, but the poison will get like stronger and stronger, and he will eventually get blown away by that. And I will get out of this with a substitute. Yeah, I don't think he can beat me now. This guy found a way to choke this, even though he dodged 4 focus blasts. Okay. Good players, but I should not talk. I definitely didn't play optimal in this life. Yeah, so you guys will get a nice and long shot on life. I hope some, like, I hope some of you guys who like didn't only just subscribe for my SPL content, also subscribe for my shot on life, or the road to top 10 will definitely be a thing, so stay tuned for that. So I feel like coiling on this is fine. Maybe Southern Arrow was the play, but I just want to make sure. Of course he gets a fucking crit! Like, how often would you get bailed out? I should have Southern Arrows. But yeah, I think I still win with Scarf Tap or Lele. I'm pretty sure I still win with Scarf Tap or Lele. Yeah, okay. Nice joke, dude. Scarf Lily should win, right? Just Psychic. Moonblast Psychic doesn't matter. Same power. Like, he changes the terrain anyway. Unless it's like Scarf Coco for some reason. We have this. Let me put that Caps GG. Phew, I'm glad we made this. Yeah, let me know in the comment section if you made it this far. Because I thank you so much if you... Like, if you stayed with me for the entire live, like, this one was pretty long, I think 40 minutes plus, and we are at 1563, which is okay, so at least we gained some points. I think we started at 1530. I lost, like, 1-2 DC, so yeah. Like, we're not that high on the ladder, but if my friend BTB will be back in a few days, we might start the road to top 10. I still have to ask him, but he's, like, a really good player, in my opinion. Shoutouts to him. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please send in your teams if you have good teams. And I will see with more SPL, more shot on life, more Wi-Fi battles, but yeah, I haven't really gotten good Wi-Fi battles, so that will may take some time. I just have gotten 6-0s or some shit, because those were not upload worthy. So yeah, Dr. Sanyon, thank you guys, and stay tuned for more content. Peace out.